The short run is considered the period of time where fixed costs are still fixed. Therefore, all you can play around with are your variable costs, labor being the best example. The analysis of production in the short run must then be focused on variable costs. The upper graph shows labor used in the production process in the horizontal axis and total quantity of output produced in the vertical axis. The lower graph still measures labor used in the production process in the horizontal axis, and the average and marginal productivity of labor are measured in the vertical axis. This curve corresponds to a production function and is drawn as a function of labor. As we can see, the quantity of output grows at an increasing rate, up until the point where the straight line from the origin is tangent to the curve. From this point onward, total output will grow more slowly. The average productivity of labor increases as long as the growth rate of quantity increases. After a certain point, where the growth rate of quantity starts to decrease, average productivity starts to drop. From the output level, we can also derive the marginal productivity of labor. We can see how marginal productivity, drawn in light blue, drops with each additional unit of labor after a certain point. In phase 1, average productivity increases with each additional unit, corresponding with the first diagram up to the point of inflection. Here, marginal productivity is always greater than average productivity. We can also see that, at optimum level, the marginal and average productivity coincide. Phase 1 ends in the extensive margin, or technical optimum. Phase 2 is where we should ideally be. Average productivity drops with each additional unit, but marginal productivity is still positive. The line that separates phases 2 and 3 is called the intensive margin, or technical maximum, from which there will be too much variable input for each level of fixed input. When marginal productivity becomes negative, we enter phase 3, and we should consider reducing labor. This all relates to the productive elasticity of our product, or output elasticity, which is the difference in quantity that occurs as a result of a change in the level of productive inputs. Obviously, in phase 1, a change of one unit in labor input will produce a much larger return in production levels than itself. Since here we have increasing returns to scale, we know that the output elasticity is greater than 1. In phase 2, the output elasticity will be somewhere between 0 and 1, which means decreasing returns to scale. Lastly, in phase 3, the output elasticity is lower than 0. As we can see, the marginal productivity is negative, which means that it is technically inefficient to keep producing. As we've seen, productivity means a great deal when analyzing production in the short. Since fixed costs can't be modified, firms must allocate resources in the most productive way, and therefore must carefully look after their variable costs.